Pow! Hey everybody, I'm Cubastic. Today I will sneak into the Science Museum of the Ukrainian Academy of Sciences. This is the largest science museum in our country, which is located in the capital itself at VDNG. This is an amazing place in our city and the most crazy exhibits are located here. My task is to spend 24 hours in this museum to show you the coolest exhibits that I can find here. Today we will ride a bicycle with square wheels and grow the largest crystal in large parts of our body 1,000 times and create a real active volcano. Let's go! Just look how huge it is! As many as 2 floors of stunning exhibits! And you probably see the most important of them behind my back. This is a bicycle with square wheels, but we will return to it a little later. So far I see this mechanism. And I'm really interested to know how it works. I don't know if you've seen this before or not, but on this exhibit you can build your own island with relief, make a thunderstorm, a working volcano and everything else on it. All this is possible because there's a special projector and sensors that measure the height exactly no matter what we build here. And we will build all this with kinetic sand. Here is the trick of a kinetic sand, check it out, it's hard as a rock, like a stone. And when it just lies on the hands and no one touches it, it begins to crumble like liquid. Awesome stuff, I don't know how it works, I hold it in my hands for the first time in my life. It's super stunning. Check it out, it seems to be alive. Now let's build a real island with a large volcano with such a crazy huge mountain from which lava will flow. Let's make a lake here. And let's see how it is displayed through the projector. I don't know how it works, but the projector displays the entire relief exactly. Where the lowlands are, the color is colder, and higher the color begins to darken. Also, thanks to this ring, I can simply pour virtual water in this lake. See? And there's so much water that it starts to overflow. There will be a lake for some time until the water completely drains out. Now is the time to blow up this island. We had a volcano at the highest point and now lava flowed. But I can make a special path for the lava and the projector will know that there is a notch, and then the lava will flow exactly where I want it to flow. Here it falls into the ocean, but then I can continue to make just such a plane for it. And then it will continue to flow. This is amazing, I have no idea how it works, but it's just amazing. My volcano is flowing again. I wonder if I can raise the lava and put it here. Yes, look, it works, damn. Have you ever seen liquid glass? It is here and it really flows. There's such an improvised clock here. It shows how buckwheat and smaller cereals are poured. There's also water here and naturally the water will flow like this. But this is liquid glass because it flows so slowly and just look at how dense its structure is. A drop has formed just now, look! You can really observe it for a really long time, it looks like honey dripping from a spoon onto a sandwich, just look how cool it is! But that's not all yet, there's real hard glass here that can be made to flow. Here it is, these granules, small sand, are highly crushed glass, and the thickness of each grain of sand is literally a few molecules. These are such small elements, and if you turn them over, as you can see, it doesn't flow much because it has a really high density and it sticks so tightly to each other inside. In order for it to flow, it must be shaken well enough. The signs. Guys, everyone knows that this attraction when you need to grab something with these scary tongues. So even this attraction is approached from the point of view of science here. Look. There are three wires at the center of this mechanism. They are so thin, and I, thanks to these moving elements, put current through them, which heats up these elements. If this element is heated, then it compresses and becomes really strong and durable, and if you cool it, then it stretches again. And due to this, I control this biomechanical hand, and it's awesome how interesting it is. Science is amazing. Damn, this is just crazy. The task is to take a ball and put it in the center, but for now I can do this. The science! Work! Down! No, not to the right, down! Grab it! It's impossible. Grab it! In the next video I have prepared a puzzle called Steel Donuts for you. Interesting? Subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss it. This exhibit works according to the same principle. Here the base of these flowers are the threads that change with temperature. There is a red button here, if I press it, then such a boot will go down. Take a look. It will of course press the flowers. And if you press the red button, then you will subscribe to the channel. Please do this, because the channel needs your support. Leave your likes and comments and be sure to subscribe, because there are more than 100 of the videos on my channel and they continue to come out every Tuesday and Friday. I understand perfectly well that now there's nothing to watch on YouTube, but I will be so pleased if you stick on my channel for a few minutes or even hours. Subscribe to the channel, I will be so pleased! The flowers, as you can see, are deformed, and now warm air is blowing from the pipe. If you direct it to the flowers, they begin to gradually get up. So I just directed the air on one flower in the middle and it started to grow simply because I hit this thread. That's it! As if nothing happened, you see? And here is the glass on which the bowling ball hit 615,000 times. Damn, this is probably the toughest glass in the world, and its secret is that it is tempered. The tempered glass is not easy to break, and now, to prove it, my face will be right in front of the glass. I will move the bowling ball, it will smack me right here with all its power, and if the glass breaks, then of course it will be the last video on my channel. I hope this doesn't happen. Let's try. Now the ball is at the very top, and when I press this button, it will fall, but first I will put my face on the target. The ball will fly right here now. I press the button. Are you ready? It was so scary, 615,001. I wonder how much longer this glass will handle. Let's try again, I liked it. This is the glass that protects my face. I don't stop being scared, it's really scary. God, how emotional it is. I can't get used to having a huge bowling ball flying right into your face. You can try it yourself. Did you know that the strongest structure is not some kind of metal structure or a structure of tightly connected atoms? It's foam, the lightest and most durable in the world. And here are some examples. For example, here there are sea corals, which are light, really thin, but in the meantime everyone knows that you can scratch and hurt yourself with them. So I not recommend anyone to do it. And yes, the most common bath rubber and the dishwashing sponge have the same foam structure. Try to put, let's say, a glass of water on it, and it will withstand, because it's really durable. But there's one artificially created material called aerogel. It is extremely rare to see it, but it is known for the fact that it is also has a foamy structure. But it is the lightest and at the same time the most durable material on the planet. Let's take a closer look. Guys, I managed to get a piece of aerogel and take it in my hands. It is really light, I don't feel it at all. It weighs less than a gram, but it is super durable. Here you can see that it can withstand a wall brick, the brick that weighs a lot. And if you correctly distribute the weight, then it can hold many, many tons. This is because it has a foam structure. And the most interesting thing is that it is called an aerogel because it is 99.8% air. Imagine here, I almost hold an air and only 0.2% is the material of which it is composed. So cool, I want to bite it, but I won't. Do you hear this sound? It falls like a real piece of glass. But it's super light, I don't know how it works. Did you know that the aerogel is a space technology and it is so often used in space, because every gram you try to lift off the Earth is important there. But this material is the lightest and most durable, and I just found out that it is fireproof. So if I take the aerogel, put it on my palm and burn it with a burner, then I will feel absolutely nothing and the aerogel doesn't even deform in any way. This is a truly space technology. Despite the fact that it is really light, it is the most expensive material in the world. It is more expensive than gold and platinum. And imagine, this piece, it weighs really half a gram. And it can just cost a lot of money. Therefore, this technology is used in space. I'll probably take it with me. Hi there, Elon Musk? Yes, hi buddy. I found the aerogel. Yes, come on, look, you subscribe to the channel and I'll give you a half a gram of aerogel. Of course, yes. Guys, you also subscribe to the channel, just in case. Mm-hmm. Agreed. Okay. Bye, dear Elon. Yes. There's foam growing over there. Of course, you cannot enter here and you cannot touch it, but for your sake, I'm ready to prove to you why foam is the most durable structure on the planet. Just don't tell anyone, please. This is regular soap suds. It's a wall piece. No matter how I beat it, and at the same time it is so light. You can try this at home. Look, I'm hitting really hard, but it doesn't deform. It will only deform if I squeeze it with my fingers. And doing so, I will leave pressure marks darkly on it. Guys, you've probably already seen such a thing. This is called a ferromagnetic fluid. I operate two magnets, one on the bottom and one at the top, and you can see how it reacts to the magnetic field. It literally draws every magnetic wave. And did you know that ferromagnetic liquid is used in different fields? For example, it is used in medicine. It is injected together with the medication and then, thanks to the magnet, the ferromagnetic liquid is brought through the human body to the right place. It just blows the mind. And now we're in the zone that explains the work of crystals. And I didn't expect this, but in fact this is a super interesting topic. The simplest crystal you know is probably an ordinary snowflake. And due to crystallization, it just has such a cool shape. If you didn't know, then a snowflake is actually a piece of dust or some kind of little dirt or perhaps even a molecule on which cold water sticks and immediately freezes. I'm sure you didn't know that and neither did I until today, but in reality it is so. And there are no two identical snowflakes. Crystals can be completely different, and you know it, such as sugar, salt, perhaps a diamond. Yes, this is also a crystal, but much more dense. And here is a crystal out of a stone growing here. Look at this model. This is a silicon crystal. This is the stronger stone. This is exactly the one from which sparks are struck for the production of fire. And this huge thing grew out of a small grain of sand, simply because there are special conditions for it inside, so that silicon molecules crystallize on the main body of the crystal. But look at this huge thing here. This is also a huge stone crystal. It looks like a metal pipe, but in fact it is a huge piece of stone that weighs many hundreds of kilograms. And you won't believe it, but it all grew out of a small grain of sand which is here above, I can't even reach it. And then this crystal is cut into such discs and such half mirrors are obtained. I don't even know where it is used, but it is quite interesting. When I first came here, I thought that these were real mirrors, but it's just thinly sliced crystal. Look, damn, it's just some kind of miracle. Folks, this is not a shower or a telephone. It is a portable microscope that increases objects 1,000 times. And there are different textures here that we can see on the screen at a thousandfold magnification. For example, this is an artificial grass. Check it out. And this is the carpet. Oh. Oh. Damn. Check out the tangles of ropes. It is so similar to, like, some kind of tights or sack. I can't figure out what it is. But look, it's like some huge ropes on the screen. I'm interested in looking at my body. For example, my hand. Yeah? Come on. Where does this hair come from? I don't see it like that on my hand. This is what the prints on my palm looks like. It's horrible. I wonder what my eye looks like. I don't know if you could see it or not, I think I'm blind. This is a denim jacket stitched with a denim orange thread. Damn, so many interesting things, you can actually look at it for a long time, but we have the most interesting hat. A bicycle with a square wheels. My goodness, first of all, damn, with a square wheels. Secondly, I have always dreamed of doing it. Now, let's try to ride it. Naturally, square wheels will not work with a conventional platform, but this surface, as you can see, is made for it. And thus, the wheel here is not round, so we can ride this surface, and here you can really, really ride a bicycle with square wheels! Damn! This is so cool! This is just unbelievable! I never thought in my life that I would ride a bicycle with square wheels. And this, damn it, is possible, in fact, all thanks to physics. Here, instead of the usual round wheel, a round surface is used. It was divided into sectors, and it turns out that the round surface is in contact with the flat edge of the wheel, and therefore, at the end, it works! If we're talking about the usual road, the round wheel just turns on it, and here, on the contrary, we have a flat side of the square, and the land is rounded. Therefore, it compensates each other and makes it possible to go with square wheels! It is, of course, not so easy, but possible. Let's go! I broke something. Let's get out of here quickly. And here it is clearly demonstrated how it works. The wheel is square and the surface is rounded. It feels like the wheel is underneath and the surface is here. But the opposite is actually true, it is just compensated, and thus a wheel can be not only square but in general of any shape, but every special shape there should have a special surface, like for example here. It was the most interesting part that I could show, but it was just the first floor, there's also a second floor here, so we're going up there right now. But naturally, I don't want to prolong this video, so what is on the second floor you will see in one of my next videos. Therefore, be sure to subscribe to the channel not to miss it, turn on all notifications so that you see them and you will be the first to see this video. Thank you all so much for watching, I hope it was really interesting for you, that was Cubastic, goodbye so far and have a good time!